It was just a matter of time in your e-learning journey for you to hear about what authoring tools are. And you're probably really confused, just like we were when we first heard about authoring tools. Like, why do I need one? What is an authoring tool? Well, today we're gonna go through what an authoring tool is with three very simple to digest examples. And then we're gonna go through the two types of authoring tools that exist. And we're going to talk about the different authoring tools that fit in to those two types. My name is Johnny Havey. I'm one of the co-founders of eLearning Partners. And we created this channel because we just want to simplify e-learning for you, which is why we're answering questions like what we have today, so that you don't have to stress out and try and figure out if you need an authoring tool or not. We're just going to give you the simple answers to that question. Now, if you want to take your e-learning to the next step, what we recommend is we have a free masterclass linked in the description below this video. And our masterclass is all about guaranteeing the success of any e-learning program or online course that you create ever. And how do we do that? Well, pretty simple. When you check out the masterclass, you're going to learn all about how to figure out exactly who your learners are, what their biggest challenges are, and then we're going to give you a step-by-step process to use to create your e-learning program from start to finish, and then most importantly, getting it in front of your learners in the end. So definitely check that out. You'll get instant access once you sign up below, and it is absolutely free. But let's dive into this question today. What is an authoring tool? We have three examples to illustrate what an authoring tool is. First of all, think about the name, authoring, and think about someone writing a book. An author. So what do? They write the book. So they author something. So same thing when you're thinking about courses, an authoring tool is a technology that allows you to author or create your course. Here is our first example. I'm gonna dive into the computer now. So who here has created a video in the past, or maybe you're looking to create videos for your course, or you've had other people create videos for you. Okay. Well, there are tons of tools out there to create videos or author videos or edit videos. One of them I'm gonna have right here is iMovie. As you can see, I'm in iMovie right now. If I wanna create a new video, I click on create new, I go movie, it opens up a platform here for me to now import media that I can put into the movie, and I can basically author my video or movie using iMovie. So that's an example. An authoring tool, we can look at a graphic up here, an authoring tool is to a course just like iMovie or Adobe Premiere or Windows Media Maker or Shotcut or all these other editing tools are to a video. Here's our next example. Microsoft Word, and you'll see here I actually authored something, a written piece of content here in Microsoft Word. This is actually another video on our channel you're gonna have to check out, all about how to build out micro learning outlines and scripts. So definitely check that out. But here's what I did. I authored this document, and this is teaches how to actually create a micro learning outline. I authored this. I used Microsoft Word. That's the tool, that's the word processor, and I used it to create this written document. This is all written content. So example number two over here is a word processor like Microsoft Word or Pages. I think I have Pages here somewhere. Yeah, I guess it's not on my favorites bar. But Pages or Google Docs, those are tools, those are word processors for you to create written content. So a word processor is to written content, just like an authoring tool is to creating a course. You author it. You author written content, you author the course. Number three, for those of you who are creating a lot of graphics, you probably use a couple different softwares. One of the best ones, because it's a free software, is Canva. So Canva here, I can author or create a new graphic design just by simply clicking on create new design. Then it's gonna be like, oh, we can actually author a video here, or create a video, presentation, logo, all sorts of stuff. So I'm just gonna pick presentation so I can author a new presentation. And we'll do another example here. I can author an Instagram post. And then it's gonna give me this template to work with to create that graphic for the presentation, the Instagram post, whatever. I can create graphics in Canva. I can author graphics. So example number three here is Canva is to building graphics just like an authoring tool is to building a course or authoring a course. So three really simple to understand examples. So authoring tools for courses, for authoring a course, do you need them? Well, you are going to need some sort of authoring tool. Now the authoring tools that you have probably heard of, or if you haven't, you're going to hear of them very quickly after watching this video because they're the most popular authoring tools out there, are what we call standalone authoring tools. So you can see right here, a standalone authoring tool. What does that mean? Well, there's two types of authoring tools. There's standalone authoring tools, and then there's native authoring tools. A standalone authoring tool is an authoring tool that exists independently of a learning management system. What is a learning management system? Well, if you want to know all about what a learning management system does, we have a video either linked up here or up here. Definitely check that out. We really simplify what a learning management system is in that video. But what we want to tell you is a learning management system in its simplest terms is a system or a technology that your course lives in, that you then deliver the course to your learners. Well, when we talk about authoring tools, there are some learning management systems that have an authoring tool built in known as a native authoring tool. If you have a native authoring tool, it is an authoring tool that is built into an LMS natively. A standalone authoring tool is not part of the LMS, so you can't host and deliver the course to your learners and create it with that technology. That would be an LMS that doesn't have a native authoring tool, okay? But there are plenty of authoring tools that exist independently of an LMS, and those are called standalone authoring tools, and that's what we're gonna dive into first. The two most popular standalone authoring tools are Articulate 360 and Adobe Captivate. So let's look at Articulate 360 here. Articulate 360 isn't just one authoring tool, it is a suite of authoring tools. As you can see here, Articulate 360 is used by a lot of companies. We got Microsoft, GE, Target, eBay, Google, Visa, etc. Lots of companies use Articulate 360. So Articulate is similar to investing in a suite of tools, okay? So just like you have Adobe Creative Cloud where you have Photoshop, Premiere Pro, After Effects, Media Encoder, there's a bunch more. Here's all the apps. Illustrator, Acrobat, there's all sorts of apps. That's what Articulate 360 is when it comes to course creation, a suite of apps, the two most popular ones being Storyline and Rise. Those are the two most popular authoring tools within the Articulate 360 suite. Why are there so many different types of authoring tools? Well, there are a lot of different types of courses that you can develop. Storyline, for example, is a very comprehensive authoring tool for courses. It can do a lot of custom design. Rise, on the other hand, is meant for responsive course design. What does responsive mean? That means that you create a course for the desktop, but it also looks nice on your phone. It also looks nice on your tablet. Responsive design. Rise simplifies responsive e-learning course design. Storyline allows you to do a lot of custom e-learning course design. What you can actually do is take a storyline file and import it into Rise. So we're getting kind of complicated here. But Articulate 360 is a suite of authoring tools, with the two most important ones being Storyline and Rise. Here's an example of what Rise looks like, or a course in Rise looks like. And here's what we mean by it being responsive. So here's the desktop view, and I can go to a tablet portrait view. I can go to a tablet landscape view, and I can go to a phone mobile portrait. I go to mobile landscape. So when you design something in Rise, which, like I said, is a sub tool or a part of the Articulate 360 suite, you're gonna make it automatically responsive. Okay, so the other main standalone authoring tool is called Adobe Captivate. Now, interesting thing about Adobe Captivate is if you subscribe to the Adobe Creative Suite, Captivate isn't part of it, okay? Captivate is its own standalone software that Adobe sells. So let's look at Captivate a little more. As you can see, Captivate really focuses on PowerPoint course buildouts. Or if you can't see, because I'm not showing that many details about it, it's much more rudimentary than Rise or Storyline, which are part of Articulate. Very important to know that. Rise and Storyline are part of Articulate. Captivate is its own thing. So also, if you do some research on Captivate, you're gonna see that huge organizations are using Captivate as well. Two examples would be, first of all, Kajabi. So Kajabi is one of the best, if not the best LMS for anyone out there looking to create a course and sell it to your consumer, okay? Kajabi has a lot more capabilities than just an LMS. You can actually market and sell the course using Kajabi as well. If you're interested to learn more, we have a 30-day free trial we can give you, which is an extended trial that you can't just get from Kajabi.com like you see here. So if you check out our link below this video for that. But the cool thing about Kajabi is it has its own authoring capability. So you don't actually need a third-party authoring tool like Captivate or Articulate. So you can save money there and you can build your course within Kajabi. The negatives of that are if you want your course to live in anyone else's LMS ever, you'll have to rebuild it in that LMS because Kajabi does not author the course using SCORM or Tin Can. If you want to learn more about SCORM and Tin Can, we have another video, definitely check out that link. We simplify SCORM and Tin Can in that link. Otherwise, just disregard what I'm saying related to that. If you've never heard of that, don't complicate things for yourself. Definitely check out Kajabi though, if you are looking to create and sell your course. And like I said, you don't have to pay for an authoring tool then. TalentCards is another example of an LMS that you can author your course within. And cool thing is, the pricing is also right. It is very, very inexpensive. Now, TalentCards is an extremely solid LMS choice when it comes to internal training or training your employees and internal teams. So if you're building an externally facing program or a program you're trying to sell to consumers or customers, we do not recommend TalentCards. It's gonna cost too much to get the marketing and sales technology that you need, the e-commerce integrated in order to do that. So definitely use TalentCards if you're looking to train your employees and specifically you want an LMS that's mobile first focused. The cool thing about TalentCards though is you can build out your course within TalentCards and you don't need a third party authoring tool because it has a native authoring tool. Pretty cool. We have other videos on our channel that go into how to build out courses in TalentCards, so definitely check that out. And we also have whole playlist actually dedicated to Kajabi. So definitely check that out if you want to learn more about how these LMSs work and how their authoring tools within them work for these courses.